right, so this first part of the video is going to show how to create an actual histogram based off of a continuous data set. So I know this is continuous data because it's in minutes. And let's just say it's data based on students taking a 50-minute test and how long it took them to actually complete the test. All right, so looking at this, there's a couple of different ways that you can do a histogram. I'm going to do the long way first, so it's a little bit, you know, more intense. The very first thing I would do, though, is I would sort the data so you can kind of see the low 28.7 and the high, so all these people are going past time, 57.8. So 28.7. And 57.8 minus 28.7. So I can see a spread there, the range, okay, of about 29 values. And the only reason why I did that is because maybe I want to then figure out how many bins I would have and the width of the bins. This is completely up to me, okay? So I'm going to say bins. I'm going to do, so if I'm sitting here just thinking, if I do 28 to, let's say the low, so the low side, let's say 28 to 30, and then 31, so 28, 29, 30 is 2, right? So I'm adding 2 each time. So I'm going to do this so I can just copy it. That plus 3, so 28, 29, 30, that plus 3, I didn't count, 28, 29, 30, 3, right? And the reason I did that is so that way I can just copy this straight down. And where were we stopping? 57. So I can already look at this and see this might be too many bins, right? Because there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Maybe not, you know, maybe you're fine with that many. But let's try something a little different. Let's try 28, 29, 30, 31 to 32. And I was hoping that it would update everything, but apparently not. So 28, 29, 30, 31, 32 equals these plus 5. So I'm going to take that one. Oops. Plus 5. And then copy this straight down once again. And now I see, what was, I keep forgetting my high value, 57.8. So if this is the high, then I need this bin, right, for 57.8. And so again, they, you know, they tell you between 5 and 15 is fine. That's completely up to you, you know, how you decide to do these. Now, there's, I mentioned in another video, there is a frequency formula that will count for you, but I kind of just do this on my own. So I use the count formula, and I'm going to count from 28 to below 32. So I'm not going to select that one. So there's only one. So now I'm going to do the count for above 32. Okay, so this 33 is really, so in other words, this is the high. Okay, is really all I need is the high count. And so here this would be 32. To where am I stopping? 37. And I'm actually going to use 37, so I can use that one. And then next, I'm going to start at 38 and stop at 42. That looks like those. Next, I'm at, 42 over, and then stopping at 47, and there's actually a 47. And then next, so I stopped at 47. I'm going to go 47 to 52. So there's a group of those. So anything under 52. And then next, I'm going to go anything that's over 52 and stopping at 57. So that would be these. And I can kind of already see my last one's by itself, so I'm just going to put a 1 there. Okay, so in other words, with my bins here, might kind of make a little bit more sense to just say that's my, based off of this, that's the lowest value. Or I'm sorry, the highest value. Okay, so 32.0. And probably should put these in one decimal place since that's how the information over here was given. All right, now one thing I do quite often, because my eyes sometimes will miscount, is I sum that to see, do I have 48 values? And you might say 49, but that one's at the minute. So I did correct with that. Okay, and so now from here, I want to actually create my histogram. As I mentioned, there's actually a couple of different ways to do this. Well, since I've done all of this information now, I can actually just highlight this information, go to insert, and go to my bar graphs. Okay, now the only thing you're going to notice though is it's like, but why is it doing 2? Well, even notice it says bins, the blue. Well, I don't want to graph those, so I could either just highlight the frequency. So let's go back and just highlight the frequency. And I said, or I could have just simply clicked on the bins and hit delete. But that looks good. So that's not a true histogram. This is a bar chart, right? Because a bar chart is discrete. Okay, so it actually has these discrete values. So what I would kind of like to do based off of my information here is I would like to close those gaps. And there's a way to do that manually. You right click on any one of the bars, you go to format data series, and right here it says gap width, and you just change that to 0. The only problem though is it's not showing each bar. So what I would like to do is my border, I would like to change it to a color that I can actually see those lines. So that's what the border was. Okay, and so that's, you know, one way to make the histogram. Now let me show you something. If I highlight all of this again and I do insert, and I told you you could do this, and then you could just click on the blue ones and hit delete. That's all I was saying, you know, based off of doing this the same way. All right. Another way is if you have the data analysis, there is a histogram. I say okay, but notice it, so my input range is going to be these values. So let me just highlight my input range. But then notice the bin range, you still had to actually do a bin range. All right, so I did that. Where do I want to output this? I don't know. Right there is probably pretty good. And just be sure to check chart output. And you're going to see Excel does this in a little bit different way. Okay, so you can see that it's done everything. It's done all my counts for me. So this is kind of a shortcut. If you have the data analysis, then you actually didn't have to sit and count those, you know, or have Excel count them. And then you just do the same thing. You right click and you go to, there's a cat in my way, so I can't see this down here. You go to format data series, which is already here, and you change the gap width. And as you can see, I need my borders, so a solid line, and black is fine. Okay, so same graph, right? Might look a little different, but it's just because this one's bigger, so I can make it bigger. And all that kind of good stuff. All right. If you have, so I only need one. If you have the newest Excel, this really, really nice. I can actually take and select my data, go to insert, recommended charts, all charts, and if you look here, you're going to see, so I'm in all charts, histogram. And so if I click that, then automatically it does a histogram for me. And notice it did a little bit better with the grouping. And why do I say better than this one? This has more of that normal shape to it than this one does. So it grouped better, and it shows you here how it grouped them. All right. So I'm actually going to keep this one. And then, as I always mention, you should title your chart. You can double click and say that this chart is time to complete test, you know, something like that. But now I have an actual histogram that I can answer, you know, questions with. Looking at the data set, does appear to be somewhat normal, okay, that bell-shaped curve, and I can do other things with this information.